teaching of archaeology at the Institute at the Hebrew University started in 1926, so shortly after the foundation of the university. This is basically the faculty of people who were teaching archaeology: Eliezer Sukenik, Leo Meyer, and Moshe Shtekelis. Not all from the beginning, but in the first years. In 1948, the university left Mount Scopus was housed in the city. The collections, the artifact collections of the institute, mostly remained on the mound. You see the whole of the collections, as you know now, with the ossuaries is still inside. So the university was housed in all kinds of places in the city. These are the red dots are for the Department of Archaeology only, like the teaching and mostly the storage spaces. In the 1960, the institute moved to newly built Givatran campus. This is the building of the Institute of Archaeology, which is now a joint Israel building, just outside the campus. And after the war, after 1968, the department decided to go back to Mount Scopus after several other ideas. So in 1971, the institute moved back to the Mount, and several years later, another building was added to the institute. So altogether, this is the plan of the this part of the campus, so on the Mount Scopus. The building of the student club, which was student club before constructed in 1936, which is now part of the institute. Another building, which was like the first house of the department and the collection of the Jewish antiquities, the Beit HaMechot, and the first, the last wing built in 1972. So all three together now are the building of, which you know, which is really easy to get lost in.
The alarm is ready. Yeah, we
can do that. So in this new building on the roof, I conducted an excavated an excavation in 2014 and 15. It has a very nice view, like a good excavation bed. Inside the room, it was much less romantic. This is how the archive was found, not in a good shape at all. Beside them, these are the two crates that the archive of the Israel Exploration Society dug, the one presented by Chloe. And thanks to Chloe, now it looks much better. In terms of the content, what we have in the Institute Archive, first of all, the research archive, we see some partial list of the excavation record. The first, the upper part of the list was already moved to the Antiquities Authority Archive, and the lower part still doesn't, but we keep digital copies of everything. Another ring of the collection of the archive is the visual archive, so around 50 1,000 slides, collection of negatives of all the institute excavations, and legacies like the private collections of slides and others. And another part of the archive, like a separate one, is the legacy of Moshe Shteklis, the first professor of prehistory in the university. This archive was inherited by the institute several years ago, and it underwent partial cataloging, and some research researches were already conducted based on it, and Ariella will present one of them. So in terms of the time scope which is covered by the archive, we have more or less everything. So the upper timeline shows the development of the department, and the lowest physical location in the city, so kind of to give you a big picture. And during the last 2 years, Daphne Saran and myself, we conducted a research of the history of the department during the period of 1948 to 1968. And I'll show here only one aspect of this history, which regarding the relations of the archaeology and the state during these years. So in terms of teaching, the organization of the department before 1948, Department of Archaeology already existed, but still there were several groups of classes spread through the schools in the university, like general humanities and in terms of the general landscape of the archaeological institutions in the here in the Holy Land, before and after 48, it's very important to understand that whatever we had before 48, like the foreign archaeological schools and the Palestine Archaeological Museum, and also the Museum of Jewish Antiquities, all these institutions were unavailable or on the other side of the border after 1948. So the in terms of who is left inside the State of Israel was the Department of Antiquities, which is was only in its formation years, Israel Exploration Society, and the Department of Archaeology, which was the only teaching institution for archaeology and the most important in terms of research and excavations. So teaching was organized, was still spread in different departments and represented by three professors only, each for one subject. And this is the picture we have until 1942, when some problem, as we can see in the archives, there were some problems because Sukenik, Eliezer Sukenik, who was founder of the Museum of Jewish Antiquities and was teaching most of the classes, wasn't really able to continue to keep up with the pace. And there were complaints and discussions in various committees in universities. So on the other hand, Benjamin Mazar, who was teaching in the Department of Geography, was very keen on reorganizing the Department of Archaeology and putting the historical geography in the picture. So it was a conflict. And in 1943, Sukenik passed away, this reorganization happened. So it was one department with several wings, not the final. What you see here is not the final, not what we have now. What the structure we have now was adopted later in around 1959. And they, we have many new faculty members. As you can see, the topics of the interest are also different. For instance, we don't have Jewish archaeology as a subject anymore. I'll show how it happened. In terms of classes, like the amount of classes, we see a jump in 1943-4 and then a slow rise, but these are absolute numbers, so the university, yeah, goes in another direction, sorry.
Classes.
These are absolute numbers, so it doesn't reflect how it relatively to other departments. The university grew in generally, but still it shows the
dynamics.
You're already a college partner.
So, but what in general tendencies of the 1950s and 60s, we see a strong focus on biblical archaeology, development of the new field methods, which will later will be defined as Israeli method, but it's a different story. But still, cultural history is a theoretical background of the research conducted. This focus on biblical archaeology was pretty much brought from the from above, but also accepted by archaeologists themselves. This is from a speech of David Ben-Gurion in 1949, when he says that what we have, like the two treasures we have, are the land and the book, and we should study both. So we should go and excavate the land, take the book and excavate the land deeper. As an effect of this, we see in the 1965, Nachman Avigad, done in the archaeological congresses, says that it's actually we have a paradox that we know as our material culture from the third millennium BC better than this from the first century AD. Yeah, so we excavate. The involvement of the governmental bodies in archaeology went down to the decisions of what to dig and what are more important sites to dig. Like in this meeting in 1954, Minister of Culture suggests digging Tel Beersheba because it's an important site, and he's answered that actually Hatzor is more important and it's waiting for Yadin to come and dig it. Also in the international scene, archaeology was a visiting card of the state. This exhibition of Tel Hatzor finds in London was covered very well in the British and the American press. And also Elizabeth, Queen of Belgium, came to attend the opening of the new institute building in Givat Ram, and she also visited the archaeological site of Beit Shearim, for instance. These good relations with the state also very important for the logistics of the fieldwork. Having like Benjamin Mazar as president of the university, and Itzhak Ben-Zvi as the president of the state, and Igal Yadin as ex-chief of the IDF was very helpful. It's actually archaeologists were could count on help in the infrastructure almost actually everywhere. Like here, Yadin mentions all the companies and the governmental bodies and IDF who helped him to conduct excavations, and also Avigad. And in many projects, the Israel Exploration Society was the one who was actually taking care of all the logistics, like here in the survey of Judean Desert, where Abraham himself attended, like.
I'm sorry, you cut away two persons who are also in this picture.
I don't have.
Aharonim and Pesach Baradon. This one is standing here, one is standing here.
I believe it, but this is the picture I had. I don't know. Sorry.
It's a famous picture.
Bolshevik.
And Abraham is still alive.
One of the ways where we see this good the relations with the state is the construction of the location of the Institute of Archaeology in Givat Ram, which wasn't in the inside the campus, but was between the campus of the university and the what's called here the campus, Akeria, which is a governmental campus, called governmental campus now. So it was like close, really close to the governmental bodies. Also, this pink place in the between the university and the campus, which is museum campus now, wasn't built yet. But this actually. Another story I'll tell you in a minute. So the institute was built and was opened by Elizabeth, Queen of Belgium, as I said. In order to create a connection still to the campus, it's facing this wall, which is around the bus stop in Givat Ram, as you know, and it's decorated with the symbols from finds from archaeological excavations like lamella stems and the Hatzor stela.
By Danziger.
Nachon. So after this, it seems that we come to a moment of some crisis in the relations and the. There were several reasons for this, but one of them I think is around the planning, like the further planning of Givat Ram. So there are documents that say that the museums, like the building of the institute, should be accompanied by other three buildings: the Museum of Archaeology, the Shrine of the Book, which would have the scroll, scrolls, and the Department of Antiquities. And it says that they should be all in the area of the university. As we know, all three buildings were constructed, but they are outside, and constructed not immediately. So Israel Museum was inaugurated in 1965, and the Shrine of the Book was supposed to be part of the National Library and located in front of the National Library building in Givat Ram, but there was basically a fight which Binyamin Mazar, the president of the university, lost, and so the shrines. The shrine was built in the territory of the Israel Museum. And so the scrolls, which actually belong to the university, are housed there. And this was the largest loss for the university because the scrolls were acquired from the university money and were subject of the most important research conducted by the institute during these years. So in terms of these relations with the state, well, they're not always good. I can see three stages. I didn't give them names in order not to make it judgmental or something, but I'd say that the first period is period of formation of these relations, and then between 1953 and 1964 they are really good, and then not so good, also because the state needed less this constant support of ideological support from my archaeologists, but and at least until the next wave on which Masada was excavated. Yeah, thank you.